Now I am indeed honored to welcome and invite Sivananthi Thanenthiran, Executive Director of Arrow, for her opening remarks and for the virtual launch of Arrow's Media Training Manual on Gender Equality for the Asia-Pacific region. As we all know, Siva is a committed activist and leader for social and gender justice, and she strongly believes that the new normal needs to be feminist. We are all with you, Siva, on that. Under her leadership, Arrow has expanded its work to include the intersections of sexual and reproductive rights and critical development issues such as climate change, migration, and disabilities. Over to you, Siva.
Thank you, Shobha. I hope you can hear me clearly.
Yes, very clearly.
Great. Firstly, let me thank the CNS team who has been really amazing and putting together this wonderful manual, which I believe that Bobby and Shobha will like show later, you know, which is a very thorough, it's a very comprehensive manual. I wanted to thank them for their hard work in bringing everyone together today as well. And thank you all for joining us. I know that digitalization has made it more accessible for many to join, but we are also mindful that, you know, it has been a hard year for all of us, as Shobha said, a hard 2 years. Many of us have lost those who are dear to us. Many of us have seen those who are who fell sick and had to do caregiving jobs around us. So it has been difficult on so many different counts. And thank you for making the time over these next 3 days in order to join us. So what we have seen during this time of 2 years has actually shown us that burdens at the household and individual levels have shifted so significantly, right? Government was not able to handle all of the full effects of the COVID crisis, whether it was the health crisis, and now what we can see an economic and social crisis that is taking place at country level. We can already witness around us, right, either more households and more families falling into poverty or facing economic constraints. In that, the gender dimension is really amplified. So we can see girls dropping out of school, children dropping out of school in order to support their families. We can see rising numbers of families who are forced to do child early and forced marriage in order to kind of shift, you know, the economic burden away from families. At the same time, we saw health services being completely taken up by having to handle COVID, right? And in having to handle COVID, what has happened is that critical services, whether they were antenatal services, maternal health services, family planning services, young people's services, adolescent and sexual reproductive health services, all of this were kind of deemed as unnecessary. But following that was, of course, you know, unintended pregnancy, rise in maternal mortality, and especially even during COVID-19, only I think in this year did even in Malaysia, which already has a rather extensive health service, did we even see that a rise number of maternal deaths because women who had contracted COVID were exceptionally vulnerable in the care that they needed to give, and the health system was not able to extend that care to them. At the same time, we are living in a time where there's been great constraints on the free press, right? We can see that across country, due to this pandemic, either emergency measures have been put in place, or in a number of countries that a lot of, constraints on the free press according to what can be covered, what can be said, and what cannot be said. Free press and the media is, of course, you know, a fundamental pillar of democracy. And this is really important that the media is able to report on these issues of gender inequality, is able to, or social inequality that is taking place at country level. And this is something that we need to keep in mind. The other thing that has emerged with digitalization over the last decade or so was the fact that media was no longer just about press and television, right? All of us are in one way a media producer because we have access to social media. And that is why I'm really pleased that, you know, CNS has also called those who consider themselves activists, social activists, to enter into the scene, because you are also producers of media. You do it through the work that you do, either in your outreach to communities themselves, or they are also something that you also produce media either on your social media websites of your organization or of your own self. So I think in this, it's really useful to keep in mind the real necessity of bringing up the issue of gender equality within all of the work that we do and applying that lens. So I really welcome all of you willing to spend the next 3 days with the CNS and Arrow teams, as well as many of the experts who have kindly given up their time in order to be with us, in order to share their insights and their knowledge with us. So over to you, Shobha.
Thank you very much, Siva. And the media training manual on gender equality for Asia Pacific region, to which Siva was referring, is live now, and the link is there in your chat box. So it's already there for all of us to see. And thank you, Arrow and Siva, once again.